Hi everybody, this is Angie from Tourangie.com, and today I have left Mercer County, Crane Creek Road, Cherokee Road, and headed into McDowell County near Ashland, West Virginia. This is Route 17. I think it's still called Cherokee Road, but we'll pass Totem Pole Road. The Ashland Resort is up there. We're going to talk a little bit about four-wheeling and stuff. There's back a ways a little bit. We talked on the other video the other day about Crane Creek and stuff. So there's a lot of four-wheeling places, cabins and houses to stay at on the way, on the Mercer County side. But today we're going to talk all about McDowell County. The Indian Ridge Trailhead is over here, where on the other side of that mountain, Windmill Gap, Prosperity School Road, and all that Montcalm, Matoka area, was the Pocahontas Trailhead. So now we're talking about the Indian Ridge Trailhead of the Hatfield-McCoy Trail. It's actually part of it's on the Ashland Crumpler Road, just down the road from where we're at now. Ashland has a little convenience store kind of thing. The little, well, it says it's a Coal Camp Cafe. That's what it says. But there's some conveniences down there in Ashland, for the tourists in this area who are coming to explore West Virginia. There's also Wild Willie's ATV Resort, parts, repairs, and rentals. This road right here will follow along the North Fork Elkhorn Creek, and eventually, instead of going up Crumpler Mountain, this road will come out in North Fork, and that is where I'm going to mention somebody who had been commented on one of my pages, or one of the Facebook pages, the Bluefield Facebook pages, that he was from North Fork, and wouldn't mind having a video of that area. So I hope he enjoys this video. He may be familiar with some of this because this is going to head right up to North Fork. So here's a little shout out to Michael Stewart. He was from the North Fork area. He may remember this road heading to North Fork, but not by Route 52. And I'll have another shout out to him on the next video of North Fork on Route 52. So there are a couple little unincorporated little towns I'll mention. That'll be on this path, on this Cherokee Road. Before I see if I can come up with some sort of history, there's a little unincorporated town called Worth, and then Rolfe and Gilliam. Back to four-wheeling. Oh, there's also, what is, I'm not familiar with this name. Algoma. That is located nearby too. That's a little unincorporated little area. Anywho, but like I was saying, with four-wheelers, and this has become the major tourist attraction. You can ride a four-wheeler on this road, on the actual paved road, and access these Hatfield-McCoy trails. There are cabins, houses to rent. Like I was saying, ATV. If you break down on the ATV, there's all kinds of stuff. Indian Outlaw cabins out here, West Virginia ATV lodging. There's probably more, and I'm just missing naming them. Even at the top of Crumpler Mountain, there's a Crumpler Mountain Resort, and there's, gosh, like, and honestly, this one and the Pocahontas, they're just neighbors. The trail system's just neighbors, so they can intertwine. I'm sure you can get to the wagon wheel ATV resort and Pinnacle Creek ATV campground from here too. It's more probably from the Matoka Montcalm side, but just go over the mountain. I'm sure there's trails that do that. There are plenty of maps available. I had got my map down in Bramwell, and it talks about this area here, which would be the Indian Ridge area. It's Keystone and North Fork. I'm sorry, I keep calling North Fork Norfolk, and I know better. It's North Fork. But there are plenty of places that have these maps. The corner shop down in Bramwell had this map. So definitely get you a map or go to the Hatfield McCoy Trail and website and look into it a little bit more. But there's Indian Trail. Let's see. Let me take a quick glance at this. It's going to show that Route 17 and Route 13 are paved roads that you could drive on. And there's tons of little routes in there. Gosh, there's tons of ATV trails. I tell you, it's unbelievable. Ashland Campground, points of interest. There's overlooks. So, yeah, tons of... And just, it's beautiful country out here. So, definitely, if you're a four-wheeler, go to Hatfield McCoy Trails on website and check it out. All right, so we're going to pop into a little bit of history that I can come up with. Like I said earlier, I'm not as familiar with this area, but I can find some things just digging around on the internet and Wikipedia, so I figure I would mention those. The Ashland Company store, and I have already mentioned that, but it is actually on the U.S. National Register of Historic Places. It was built in 1907, and it's a two-story brick and stone foundation. It held at one point in time a warehouse, the paymaster's office, a post office, and company stores. The post office left in 1991, but on the property there was also a gym, so that's pretty cool. Alright, so we're going to talk a little bit more about Ashland here in McDowell County. Somebody famous is from here, Garnet Mims, born in 1933. Was American singer, a soul music, rhythm and blues. Anyway, there was a song called Cry Baby in 1963. Anyway, he was the lead singer of the band, which had his name in it, Garnet Mims and the Enchanters. And that Cry Baby song was later recorded by Janis Joplin. So, that's pretty interesting, isn't it? So that's some interesting little bit of information for you, from somebody famous from Ashland, West Virginia. So, since we've crossed over the mountain, I had talked about the Bluestone River over in Montcalm area. Well, the river system that's over here, or well, it's creek really, is Elkhorn Creek. And the North Fork of Elkhorn Creek is near Ashland. So, just a little bit more information about the water stuff. Let's see what else I can come up with. So, as with many of the videos over here in Southwest Virginia, coal is the main thing. And there was a road right up here, Crumpler. Took you up Crumpler Mountain up here. And Crumpler is still considered in McDowell County. And there's less than 200 people that live there. It's probably not even that anymore. But that was a mining community and still considered part of the Pocahontas Coal Company area. there, you know, the railroad tracks always taking coal. So coal, railroad, it all goes together. But one of the things that was pretty interesting is the mining houses. And you'll notice this even through driving this section of the road, you'll see it more on other videos that I'm doing on through McDowell County. But the coal companies themselves basically owned these little towns, and you know, they owned the houses, they owned the little convenience store, the company store, they owned everything. And that was the case for Crumpler also. Same thing here with Ashland. And you know, many activities evolve basically around, you know, the company store. But the houses, they're all, you know, mining houses. They're all similar look. Some of, you know, small, similar look. I read somewhere that somebody had wrote that they were all painted tan when the coal companies owned them and everything. But that's how it was in the coal camp houses. And, you know, some of the houses were quite big in certain areas, but they looked very similar and everything. But the miners, they got paid in something called scrip, which was, you know, coal company money that you could only use at the company store. But, you know, your food that was purchased, your, you know, the house, everything that you did was paid for with the coal company or the coal scrip. So you didn't really get real money, or a lot of real money, so to speak, because you were paying the coal company. So unfortunately, that's as odd as that sounds, it is in a sense a little bit awful too, because you know, you really weren't making money. You were making money for the coal company that was back then, again, making more money off of you because you were buying the food off of them and renting the house off of them and so forth and so on. So yeah, being paid in scrip. But you'll see some of the houses through here. We don't go up towards Crumpler, but through Ashland, and then you'll on through when I get on Route 52. We're going to end up in Kimball up Carswell Hollow, and you'll be able to see some of that with the houses too. Now, of course, the houses aren't all painted yellow or beige anymore, but the company store in all these little communities, they all had a company store. And that's where you bought everything from, groceries and sometimes some clothing, just whatever you needed to buy, you bought it at the company store. So earlier on in this video, I mentioned a place that I was shocked that I had not heard of, or it didn't seem right. It was called Algoma. I'm honestly quite shocked. I had not heard of it. Just by doing some research and all, I'm looking into coal mining disasters or things that have happened with coal mines. And there was a coal mine in Algoma. It was Algoma number 7, Algoma Coal and Coke. And September 15th of 1902, there was a disaster of some sort, whether it was fire or explosion or whatever. But yeah, it was in Algoma, and that's just right up the road here. You're going to be seeing it in the video if you haven't already seen it. And it was, oh, actually, it was an explosion. I see that now. It says explosion. 17 people were killed. So there are tons of deaths always associated with coal country, and all mines everywhere have deaths. But there was a list I came across that was talking about different disasters with the coal mines, and I found that one. I was like, oh, I know that name now. Okay. We'll be mentioning a few more of them through the rest of our little trip down the rest of Route 52. There's a couple that I might mention in another video later that are not actually not driving by that road we're in exactly that area, but at least I'm in the same county. So I will mention those too. But the amount of coal mining disasters that have happened in West Virginia since, well, the late 1800s, quite a number, I do have to say. So, but that's throughout the whole state, not just Southwest Virginia. All right, this is Angie from Tourangie.com. Come to my website, read my blogs, make appointments so I can help you plan your next travel adventure, whether it's a road trip like I've been doing, driving around all over, or a cruise, a all-inclusive vacation, a trip to Europe, which I'll be doing in December. Just give me a yell. I can help you with anything. Talk to y'all later. Hope you enjoyed this video.